Another edition of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. Chef Sam Choy, I'm Stew Chef John Vinaire.
And we're at the home of Hoku and Imua Garza. And I heard they can't cook, but they sure can play music.
The Opihi Pickers, and they've made some recent music pretty funny.
That's right. Let's go check them out.
After you.
And I think the scene is gonna be hey on a wa, hey on a wa, hey on a wa, you know, hey on a no, ah, hey on a no. Welcome to Hale.
Let's go. Wow, my
aloha.
God. Aloha. Hello. What an honor. What an honor.
Good to see you.
Both of you guys here, my man. Aloha.
Thank you.
Let's go, right. let's go to the kitchen.
Welcome, welcome.
See what
the
we
Garzas.
Get.
Hoku's house, but Imua comes over how often?
Whenever we film for Sam Choy. And then some, when I'm tired and I'm close by, I come by the Garza house.
Do you cook?
I cook a mean eggs, over easy, scramble.
Nice.
Yeah. It's all in the crack, yeah.
It's what?
It's all in the how you crack the egg.
Oh, okay, because I swear I heard you say it's all in the crack, but
in the fridge.
Let's go.
Nervous?
Yeah, I'm real nervous.
Oh, man, John, right up your alley. We got some chicken breasts.
Nice.
We got some burgers. Ground beef. Lean, huh? Ground beef.
Try two.
Look at him, don't look at me.
Wow. We got eggs in there. We got some cheese.
Some cheese.
And some fruits in there.
Okay. Peppers.
So what is it, spinach? What is it? Avocado.
Long avocado.
That's leftover chili right there.
Leftover chili, we're gonna do something.
You know what? I don't think we've ever done anything with chili. That'd be kind of interesting.
We've never done what we're gonna make, but we're gonna make it right now.
But don't forget, we also have box choy.
Oh yeah, where's the box choy?
Here we go. Everything that we have in here has to be incorporated into whatever Uncle Sam's planning on making. So,
sounds good.
Do the honors.
Let's see. Okay. Okay, let's take a look here, Brother Hokes.
All right, we got that mousse.
So we have here barbecue sauce.
Ooh.
Aloha.
Aloha style.
Barbecue sauce.
We have, how convenient, our last name.
Garza, wow.
Cooking chili, let's see what happens. And in the mystery box, we have a couple wieners here. Hot dogs, hot diggity dogs. And last here in the box, we have...
Hey, that's you, man, when you were coming to school.
That looks like my brother, actually.
Wow.
No foods, luau kit.
Luau kit.
Six traditional luau dishes.
Wow.
Awesome.
Okay, also contains Hawaiian iced tea. That might go good with the Coke. I don't know.
And that is box.
And that is the whole box.
Bye.
Okay, let's get started. What are we doing first?
John, was that you when you were young?
That was not me. I have never looked like that.
Maybe you?
Maybe.
Oh yeah, fire knife dance.
Hey, take off your shirt and put fire in your hands.
Hamburger goes in.
This is where the magic begins.
This is where the rubber meets
where
the road.
The cat is being, not the cat, the rabbit is being pulled out of the hat. Oh, I gotta watch this onion cutting
without crying.
You're more than welcome to do it for me because it's gonna end up being painful.
So egg goes in. Oh man, John, look at the tomahawk cutting board.
For whatever reason, you decided to go right past this.
Oh,
John, where'd you find that? So now what we got in here is the eggs and the burger. Okay. And mix that. I need the onions, John. Perfect. Just put them right on here.
Saute.
And we get a little oil.
What's the best kind of oil to use?
I like canola. Canola, pretty neutral vegetable oil.
Canola, okay.
You cook? You more?
I cook. I have three kids. I cook a mean cereal. Maybe Cinnamon Toast Crunch, maybe Captain Crunch. The options are limitless.
Captain Crunch. Peanut Butter Crunch, my favorite of all cereals. I would like to say real quick, I want to stop real quick.
Yeah.
I want to say congratulations to you, by the way. Engineer of the Year, won a big Hoku. That's awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah, but a moose.
Yeah. It's good fun.
Proud of you, proud of you.
Wait, where's your trophy, the Hoku?
It's in the studio, yeah. Yeah, it's in the studio.
Yeah, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
What was it actually for? Because, I mean, you've helped out a couple of people.
Yeah, so this past year, I was working on a lot of projects, and the project that won Engineering of the Year was Kimye.
Yep, bamboo.
So her, yeah, so,
oh, the,
so the song Bamboo, I was a part of that, and so that one song of the year, and then her album that I engineered along with my friend Black Jules Pepper. Washington. So we
Black Pepper.
So we won that.
Awesome.
Good fun.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
And we'll get to some of the other songs that you have done that have made its way onto our show.
Oh, sure.
A little later in the show.
So for the olive oil, do I shift it around?
No, just we're going to throw the onion as soon as John, that's enough onion. Just save half.
Wow, it's pretty good. He's fast.
Look at that. Johnny's fast. You know, the first time I told him how to do that, I didn't teach him. I mean, he just went and did it. But no. In here. Lucky I'm fast, huh?
Wow.
Oh.
I gotta watch how you did that.
Wow, that just looks good just right there.
By the way, I'm so grateful just to be right next to you that I'm crying a whole bunch. These are tears of joy, exuberation. Maybe the onions, but.
Woo! So that's all we did right here.
Wow, fast.
Your spatula. So now I'm gonna kind of like break it up.
Oh, that's, so that's good already.
Smells good too, though.
Yeah. Oh, it smells fresh.
So we gotta start looking for like a Pyrex dish to bake it in. You have like a cake pan or?
Yes, yes. To the right, top.
To the right.
To the right.
Up there, apparently.
Everything you own in the box to the right. My friend in school, every time I would ask her a question, she'd just sing everything, and so I think that just kind of carried on with me. I'd say, oh, do you know what time it is? Like, it's 11:30. You know? It's like, oh, it's drama. Yes, I love it.
I kind of do that a lot. Yeah.
Kamehameha, that's why, yeah.
Hey, cut onion, and you cut.
Okay, so now, well, you guys, I like that. I love it. We're just having fun, which you should have fun in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Oatmeal? Any kind of oatmeal?
Yes, we do have oatmeal.
Oatmeal?
Yeah.
Really?
For the meal?
So, yeah.
Is this good for oatmeal?
Oh, yeah. So we took an apple oatmeal, right? Gluten-free.
Gluten-free?
Wow.
Apple oatmeal.
Yeah.
So you're using the oatmeal in place of breadcrumbs.
Right.
I never knew I could do all this with what I have in my pantry.
Oh, yeah. You wait till you taste it, too. I'm going to a little salt. So, John, put a little bit of that oil on the bottom, just a little bit.
All over the vegetable.
Doesn't matter. Vegetable is fine. All is fine. Okay, John, put it right here. So I want to just pour it out like this.
Greater care to me?
Yeah, it's what color, yeah?
Really?
And then kind of like shape our meatloaf.
Wow.
Now, what kind of shapes do you normally make with the meatloaf?
You know, meatloaf, you can go square, you know, the old style. Okay, so you do this. John, I need the hot dogs, please.
Oh, I see what's happening.
We're making some kind of boat or canoe.
Yeah.
Oh. Right there.
Right in there.
Okay, you just close it up like this, right? Do you get do you have ketchup?
Yes, I do.
Get the gluten-free ketchup, please.
I got the organic one.
Okay, so just like that.
Wow.
So, John, can you put a right one good-sized line right down the middle? Some more?
Oh.
Ooh, okay, man.
For the back of the spoon, you kind of like just do this, right? And that goes in a 350 oven.
350 for what?
350 is ready.
Maybe 45 to an hour. That's about it.
Okay.
So that is our
first dish.
Garza hot dog oatmeal meatloaf.
Wow. I can taste that now. It's good.
Here we go.
This is a drop the mic, walk out kind of dish, I think.
Time goodness, on. That looks delicious.
That is delicious.
Cook time.
50.
Got you.
Like my friend in New York would say, delicious.
On tonight's Mixed Plate Minute, we are in Quebec, Canada, where early settlers used their leftovers to create the national dish poutine.
La pomme de terre russet.
We take russet potatoes and make them into frites. Then the fromage, the cheese curds.
De bœuf.
Base de bœuf et de poulet.
The sauce is beef, chicken gravy, potatoes, and cheese curds. Go gently into the gravy. The origin is that settlers would combine the food they had to make something for all to share.
This is comfort food with a capital C, a glorious mess of saturated fat, cholesterol, and sodium. A single serving tops 2,000 calories, exactly what Quebecois needed to keep warm in those frigid months along the St. Lawrence. Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
Okay, I need the chicken in here for the chicken long rice. So cut the chicken in threes like this. Normally you'd use like a deeper pot, but because I want to get the viewers to see the camera shot, so I'm using a lower one.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Here's me pouring in the chicken long rice.
The long rice.
Just want to make sure I get credit for cooking today. Add hot water all the way to...
Just cover them.
Cover them.
Do you have ginger in the house?
I have ground ginger.
Huh?
Ground ginger?
Oh yeah. Yeah, these guys eat healthy, this house. I just added the ginger to our chicken, just kind of sauteing it up.
Mmm, that looks good.
And maybe you can add your onions on right in here.
Ooh, too bad the viewers can't scratch and sniff their screen to smell what's actually coming out here. Organic broth.
Oh. Ooh.
Yep, and then I think our noodles, let me see if we're ready to go. Not noodles, but our long rice cellophane noodles. This is for the meal halal.
Yeah?
Hands on your hips.
Okay, so do you have a kitchen scissors or you don't?
Yes, I do. It should be the drawer right there.
Put the scissors in there and you just...
Okay, drain the noodles right here.
Get a spoon. We'll taste this. We'll get enough taste.
Ooh, yes.
Okay, so we're going to add the noodles to that. In the...
All right. Okay, double spooning. Oh, that's better than the Simon package.
Ooh, this is probably the best dish ever cooked in my kitchen right there.
Don't say that.
To date.
You look pretty healthy.
Spinach and steak.
It's called fasting.
So what's gonna happen? These noodles are gonna swell up and they're gonna absorb some of that liquid in there. Okay, so this is done. Pour it in our bowl.
That ginger is beautiful, bro.
Okay, so this dish is done.
Wow, get that.
Beautiful.
Okay, John.
Yes.
Let's look at that chicken.
Okay.
So, John, we're gonna split this, John.
Yeah. So we're going halvesies.
So we're gonna season that. Okay. So lay them all out like that.
Okay.
Do you have any kind of flour?
Organic coconut flour.
Oh, that's eating healthy.
Well, we want to make set a good example for our kids too, you know.
And for the world.
And for the world.
Okay, John. Are you,
yes.
Are you watching?
See how busy I am.
Yeah. Well, let me help you.
So turn it over like this. Okay, half of the chili goes in that.
Okay.
And can you turn that stove on to like medium low?
Sure.
Okay. So what I'm doing is I'm heating this to a medium low simmer. Mm-hmm. And that's about all I know.
Can you open the Garza?
Oh, I could do that, okay. I could do that.
Okay. Maybe put the slow-mo feature on for his...
Little sweaty.
Okay.
More nice. Fancy.
More. Okay,
good. Right there, good, yeah.
Fancy.
Okay, John, then I want you to pat this down. Hooli.
It's moving on.
Hooli. Okay. So now we're gonna brown this, okay?
Ooh.
Salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper, coconut flour.
Coconut flour.
With a little bit of olive oil on top to make the coconut flour stick.
John.
Yep.
Ha! Ha! Perfect. Look at the chicken. See the color nice?
Oh, wow. That's nice and light brown.
It's all in the presentation.
Wow. Woo, look at that, man.
Oh, it.
I think we need one more song.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, jeez.
I want to say it looks amazing.
Wow. I always had this in the kitchen, but I never thought I can make something like this.
Nice, huh?
Beautiful. That's because you don't think outside the the box.
I don't think outside the box, Choy.
Box, Choy.
Going back to the poke kit here from the luau kit, the ogo needs to be hydrated, so we're going to add this in some water. So I'm going to just
learning.
Cut them into cubes, which means what poke is. Okay, John's red bite onion, chopped onion. Then our packet, which is the salt, which I'll add a little bit, but I'm going to finish it off with something else. And where's our barbecue sauce we had, John? Do you put it back in there?
So what defines poke? Because I always thought poke was just fish.
Type of cut.
Cut. So cubed or, chopped or sliced. So because I didn't have sesame oil, I'm going to add a little olive oil, just a little bit.
Perfect.
I think we can bring our meatloaf out.
Wow.
Look at that meatloaf.
You want the chicken out too?
Yeah, it's all melted, yeah?
Yep.
Ooh. Oh, man, look at that.
Wow.
We're going to do a salad, and I'm going to make the dressing with the coconut milk, okay?
Okay.
So we're going to take our coconut milk. Bring out something. We got to go.
Bring out something. Anything you like. And what is that?
Vinegar.
Vinegar. And then, of course, Hawaii's own.
Cowboy gravy.
Our favorite water.
Who are you showing?
Oh,
yeah. No, I got eyeball, man. I'm cooking by eyeball. Back right. And then Paokai, what a bottle of salt we had, Johnny.
So, barbecue sauce, coconut mix, water, mayonnaise, pinch of salt, and some pepper. And about a tablespoon of kimchi sauce.
Wow.
Did it taste bring you guys food?
Wow.
Oh! Okay, Uncle Sam, let's recap. What do we do?
Well, chicken, chili, parmesan, Margaret's.
Mm-hmm. Margaret's chili cheddar chicken.
We did the chicken long rice,
yep,
with onions, little ginger powder, and then we added the long rice and a little bit of beef base. And then John made this wonderful 4 cups of iced tea.
4 cups of tea, that's right. From the No Foods packet, the Hawaiian tea is great. Just added a few of your kids' fruits.
Perfect.
Berries and strawberries.
And then we made the meatloaf with the nose hot dogs in there too. And this is a very good meat. And it looks nice, you can see it. And then we did the salad, kind of rustic looking on the cutting board.
Like that rustic vintage.
And then we did the poke with the cucumber. That tastes really good. You guys should try it.
Ooh, I can't wait.
Yeah, try it now.
Woo!
Okay, wait. Sam.
Open wide.
Why am I doing it in slow motion? He'll eat that slow motion. But it would have been nice to somehow incorporate this steak into our meal.
John, give up.
All right, but do you know what time it is then, right? Time to grind!
Yeah!
Time to grind!
I thought that it was hilarious that that we were coming over to your guys' house, because we've been singing a version of the song Chandelier. It's your version. We've been singing it for months. We sing it in episodes of this show, and we have you to thank. Well, how did you come up with it?
Well, at Hawaiian parties and anytime we just play music to make people laugh, I would just sing in the tutu style hip hop songs. I thought that's not really out there right now. Chalangalang hop, maybe I can call it that. I don't know. So I would take songs such as to the left, everything you own in the box to the left, with a big vibrato. I says, let's just throw that on a hip hop song.
Tutu's hip.
Tutu's hip. And if you put it together, it looks like the tutu ship. But so my email was like, oh, what's a tutu ship? I was like, no, it's tutu's hip.
Hip.
I thought hip hop, also like hip replacement, kind of like tutu's hip.
All right, guys, thanks a lot. Appreciate it. But remember,
when Sam Choi's in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Does that mean I can cook this now?
Oh, John. Give up, John. Give up.
When you get bored and there's a chandelier hanging around the house, make sure you take hold and grab it and have a little fun. Swing from the chandelier. Party girls, hey. Party girls, don't get hurt, can't feel anything. The real I learn, I push it down, push it down. Sun is up, I'm a mess, gotta get out now, gotta run from this. Here comes the shade, here comes the shade.